Hey, pedal freaks, this is Anthony from Texas Blues Alley. It's time for Tone Tuesday again. This time we're picking up from last week where we talked about how to use an overdrive pedal. This week we're going to talk about how to choose an overdrive pedal. My goal for this video is to make the task of choosing an overdrive pedal for yourself a little bit easier. If you are shopping in a store, this will be extremely useful because you'll get to try these things out. If you are shopping online, this will be kind of useful because it can help you narrow down what to look at. I'm going to present a very methodical way of testing pedals and how to find the right one for you. First question you want to ask is, how much distortion can it produce? And yes, even though these are overdrive pedals, what they produce when you turn up the overdrive knob or the drive knob or the gain knob, they are producing distortion. They are affecting the waveform. They are distorting it. They might be distorting it differently than how a fuzz pedal does, but they are still distorting the signal. So the question, how much distortion can it produce? That pertains to last week's lesson where we talked about using a pedal as a full gain device. The steps for that use are to set your amp to clean, set the pedal for maximum distortion, set your volume for about even, and your tone to match. So let's say you're in the store and you line up a bunch of pedals that you want to try. The first thing I check is how much distortion can it produce. So if I had these four pedals, I would set them all for about the same thing. I would listen for is how much distortion do they each provide. So I've picked these pedals specifically for this video because as you go from the Tube Screamer all the way across to the Dual Fusion, there are more controls on each progressive pedal, you know, a lot more fiddly things, but also they are capable of producing more distortion as you go from right to left. Let's start with the Tube Screamer. That's all you get with the Tube Screamer right there. So what can you take away by that? Well, if you're using a clean amp and you're depending on the pedal as a full gain device and you play metal, then a Tube Screamer is not going to cut it because that's all the distortion you get. Looking at the soul food. It's got a couple different modes. This one's been modded by JHS. A little bit more distortion than the Tube Screamer. The Ecstasy, or the Euphoria as it's now called. That has more distortion. It's got a couple different modes here. Change the way it sounds. And lastly, the Dual Fusion. It's got two different sides. More importantly, though, they can be stacked. The point in testing how much distortion it has or how much it can produce is not because that is how you will use it, but because that is what you are limited to if you buy that pedal. If you buy a Tube Screamer and it's the only pedal you can ever afford, you are stuck with this. With every amp that you play, if the amp is not capable of being overdriven because it's like a Fender Twin or something like that, that is all the distortion that you have at your disposal for soloing. So when you ask the question, how much distortion can it produce, you're really asking, how much distortion do I need and will this pedal work for me? So that's the first thing I listen to. The second thing I listen to is, how does the distortion sound? Because if it's a pedal that has an awful clipping circuit and it's made with cheap parts and it has a really harsh sound to it, you have to think about that, because you have to think about the sound of the distortion. Is it pleasant to my ears? I have all these pedals set for maximum gain, and they all sound a little bit differently at the maximum gain setting. They all sound a little bit differently, different from each other because the circuitry is different. But what you're listening for primarily is harshness in the high end. Now, I'm going to pick on the Dual Fusion here only because this is a very bright pedal. This is the Tom Quayle Signature. He uses a primarily dark amp, so his signature pedal in the smooth mode offers a lot of treble. So, for some people, let's say, let's forget that this is the Dual Fusion, and let's say you were trying out some pedal, and even with the tone rolled back, it wasn't any less bright than this. Depending on what amp you're mixing it with, a signal that bright will sound harsh to your ears. Now, when I use it, of course, I use it, you know, way back here, but let's say that the pedal you were using, that's just how the distortion sounded all the time. And you couldn't do anything about it. That's one of the things you want to pay attention to is, can you use the tone controls to get a pleasing amount of, or a pleasing tone to the distortion? This is obviously a subjective thing, but if you play around with enough pedals, you will find that some sound harsher than others. Now, of course, on this one, put it to fat mode, roll the tone back a little bit. It's super smooth. Okay, so number one, how much distortion can it produce? Number two, how pleasant is that distortion? Step three is, or the third question you want to ask is, how clean or transparent can the pedal be? In case you ever want to use the pedal as a primarily as a boost, you need to know, is this a mid-rangey pedal? Is this a transparent pedal? If I'm going to use it as a boost, how is it going to work? So let's talk about the Tube Screamer here. Usually when you're using it as a boost, you would have your amp set to a little bit of dirt, and then set your pedal. That's all coming from last week. But if we're going to evaluate how transparent the pedal is, we want to set our amp for clean. Because then when we kick on the pedal, it becomes very easy to evaluate what happens to your tone. In this case, if you listen to every string, you can hear that the sound gets a lot thinner, especially if we set this for even volume. So when we set the Tube Screamer to provide no boost at all, you can hear that bottom end just drop right out. Okay? So when you ask the question, how transparent can it get, for the Tube Screamer, it's not very. Let's contrast that to the Soul Food. Let's set that for absolute clean. Now let's do the same test that we did before. It's a lot more transparent than the Tube Screamer. What does that mean for you? What it means is you need to know which kind of pedal you're buying. If you want a Stevie Ray Vaughan type sound and you want a boost pedal that cuts through, then you want to look for something like the Tube Screamer that can get more mid-rangey. Transparency doesn't matter quite as much if you want a pedal that adds a little bit of nasal honk to your tone. But if you ever want to have a pure clean boost for a partly overdriven amp, then a Tube Screamer is not going to be great at that because it will always thin out your tone a little bit. So that's the third question you ask, is how clean or transparent can it get? If I'm testing pedals, I first test how much distortion it can produce, how good does that distortion sound, and then is it a clean boost pedal? How clean can it get? And then the last thing you look at is the tone controls. Because aside from the distortion, the tone controls are the thing that affect the most how the pedal is going to sound. What you're looking for with tone controls is how much control do you get and how effective are those controls at manipulating the tone. With the Tube Screamer, you get a very basic control. It just basically rolls off the treble. Okay? For me, that's not enough control for what I like. I still use a Tube Screamer from time to time. But no, there is no way to boost the bass with a Tube Screamer and keep the same amount of treble. There is no way to subtract out mid-range with a Tube Screamer, because all you have is that one control. If you move over to the Soul Food, it looks like it has the same amount of controls, but what you can do is as you test it out, you can see that it starts to thin out a little bit as you get closer to the top. Which tells you can keep your low end if you have the drive low. But you can't get that low end back if you turn the drive all the way up. So what you're looking for when you evaluate the tone controls is, am I going to lose bass? Is there any way to get that back? And how can I control the treble and shape that to be pleasing? So those are two pedals that have very limited controls. On the Euphoria, or the X, I have the old one, the Ecstasy, you have a bass and a tone control, and you've got three different modes. So as you go through those, you can hear the EQ and the overall level and the shape of the distortion changes. But with each one, you've got a lot of control. It's the same thing with the Dual Fusion. On each of those, you have a tone knob, but you've got a couple different voicings, which are all fancy ways of talking about the EQ. So what you're looking for, again, when you're evaluating the EQ, is what your different options are for retaining your low end, for shaping your high end, and just basically knowing how much control you're going to have. And from there, you can make a better decision. Let's go through a couple scenarios. Let's say you're a guy with a Fender Twin and you like hard rock. Well, right away, when you test how much distortion does the pedal have, you know that the Tube Screamer is not going to be a good choice for you because your amp's not ever going to get much past that in terms of distortion. And you know with a Tube Screamer, that's all you have to work with. So if you're a hard rock guy who has a Fender Twin, you're immediately going to be looking at the left end of this spectrum because you need a pedal that has more gain. Simply because the style of music you play requires that. Now let's say you're a guy who's a Stevie Ray Vaughan fanatic and you have a low-powered amp like a Fender Champ or a Blues Junior. You don't need probably as much distortion as you can get in these pedals, but you also need a pedal that boosts your mid-range. You don't really care about having a transparent boost. In that case, because you have a low-powered amp, you can get a little bit of grit out of it. So you can use the pedal as a clean boost. So you could look at this end of the spectrum, because these pedals have what you need. They have a moderate amount of gain. If you need more transparency, you can go with this one. If you need a mid-range bump, you can go with that one. You might not need the amount of gain that they have here. So all I'm trying to say is there's a couple of metrics by which you can evaluate all these pedals, but it comes down to what equipment you already have, what kind of music you play, and knowing how to run through those different parameters to evaluate each pedal and compare it to the other ones that are in your price range. Anyway, I hope that's useful to you. And until next time, thanks for watching.